Now go for the next topic, average collection period. It is also called debt collection period. It is calculated to know the average days or month to receive cash from debtors. Bills receivable and account receivable are added with debtors. It shows average time between credit sales and its cash collection. Credit should not be allowed for long time. Under this ratio, after selling goods on credit or service providing on credit, in how many days cash should be collected? We know in this topic. Average collection period is debtors into days in years divided by credit sales. If there is debtor turnover ratio, in such a condition, we can use alternative formula. That is, days or month in year divided by debtor turnover ratio. Go for an illustration. Total sales 25 lakh, debtors 160,000, days in years 360, cash sales 10 lakh, bills receivable 50,000, bad debts 10,000. In these questions, total sales and cash sales is given and we should find out the credit sales because debtors is related to credit sales. And for the days, in this topic, you can take 360 days or 365 days, both are correct if days are not given in the question. Now go for the solution part. First of all, credit sales means total sales minus cash sales. Total sales is 25 lakh, look here 25 lakh, and cash sales is 10 lakh, after deducting 15 lakh. Total debtors or net debtors means debtors plus bills receivable minus bad debts. Debtors is 160,000, bad debts is 10,000, and bills receivable is 50,000, after calculating 2 lakh. Now go for the debtors turnover ratio. Debtor turnover ratio is credit sales divided by total debtors. Credit sales is 15 lakh from here. And total debtors or net debtors is 2 lakh from here. After dividing 7.5 times. Now go for the average collection period or debtor collection period. It is also called debtor collection period. So, average collection period is total debtors into days in years divided by credit sales. Total debtors is 2 lakh, days in years is 360, and credit sales is 15 lakh. After calculating, our answer is 48 days. It's alternative formula. If there is debtor turnover ratio, in such a condition, we can use alternative formula. That is days in years divided by debtor turnover ratio. Days in years given in the question 360 days. And the debtor turnover ratio is 7.5 times. So, our answer is 48 days. Sometimes in the question, comparative balance sheets are given. In such a condition, we can take opening debtors plus closing debtors and to find out the average debtors. Look here. The following information is given by XYZ company. Amount is in rupees. Sundry debtors on 1st January 3 lakh and 31st December 9 lakh. Bills receivable on 1st January 1 lakh, on 31st December 3 lakh. Provision for bad debts on 1st January 30,000 and 31st December 90,000. Total sales 19 lakh, sales return 50,000 and cash sales 2 lakh 50,000. Require debtors turnover ratio. First of all, we should find out net credit sales. So, total sales minus sales return minus cash sales. After calculating, our net credit sales is 16 lakh. Now, we should find out the average debtors because opening debtors and closing debtors are given in the question. So, average debtors is equal to opening debtors plus opening bills receivable plus closing debtors plus closing bills receivable divided by 2. So, look here. Opening debtors 3 lakh, opening bills receivable 1 lakh, closing debtors 9 lakh, and closing bills receivable 3 lakh, and divide by 2. After calculating, our answer is 8 lakh. Now go for the debtor turnover ratio. Formula is credit sales divided by average debtors. Credit sales is 16 lakh and average debtors is 8 lakh. After calculating, our answer is 2 times. Now go for the next topic of the this ratio, that is the fixed asset turnover ratio. This ratio indicates how efficiently fixed assets are used in the business. Higher fixed asset turnover ratio shows better use of the fixed assets and vice versa. Its formula is fixed asset turnover ratio is equal to net sales divided by net fixed assets. Net sales means sales minus return, sales minus sales return. Net fixed assets means fixed assets minus depreciation. Now go for an illustration. Following information is given. Fixed assets 20 lakh, accumulated depreciation 4 lakh, sales 50 lakh and sales return 5 lakh. So first of all, we should find out net fixed assets. Net fixed assets is fixed assets minus depreciation. Fixed assets 20 lakh, accumulated depreciation 4 lakh, after deducting 16 lakh. And the net sales, sales is 50 lakh, sales return is 5 lakh, after deducting net sales is 45 lakh. Now go for the fixed asset turnover ratio. Formula is net sales divided by net fixed assets. Net sales 45 lakh and the net fixed assets 16 lakh. After calculating, our answer is 2.8 or approximately 3 times. Now go for the next topic of this ratio, that is the capital employed turnover ratio. Here you know very well, turnover means sales and capital employed means shareholders equity plus long term loan. This ratio shows relationship between sales and capital employed. It measures the efficiency of the capital employed in the business. Capital employed includes shareholders equity and long term debt. As ratio increase, profit also increase. So, capital employed turnover ratio is sales divided by capital employed. Always keep in mind, sales means net sales. If there is any types of the sales return, we should deduct. Now go for an illustration. Following information is given, shareholders equity 10 lakh, net sales 32 lakh and a long term loan 6 lakh. So first of all, we should find out capital employed, that is shareholders equity plus long term loan or long term debt, both are equal. So shareholders equity 10 lakh, long term loan 6 lakh, after calculating 16 lakh. And capital employed turnover ratio is formula sales divided by capital employed. Sales is 32 lakh and capital employed is 16 lakh. After calculating, our answer is 2 times. If in the question there is not directly capital employed or shareholders equity, in such a condition we can calculate it in alternative method. Look here, in this one illustration, fixed assets 24 lakh, current assets 20 lakh, cost of goods sold 60 lakh, gross profit 16 lakh and current liabilities 12 lakh. First of all, sales. Sales is cost of goods sold plus gross profit. So after calculating, our answer is 76 lakh. Capital employed. There is shareholders equity plus long term loan. If they are not given in the question, we can use the alternative formula, that is fixed assets plus working capital, and the working capital is current assets minus current liabilities. So fixed asset is 24 lakh, current assets is 20 lakh and the current liabilities is 12 lakh. After calculating, our capital employed is 32 lakh. Now go for the formula. Capital employed turnover ratio is equal to sales divided by capital employed. Sales is 76 lakh from here and capital employed is 32 lakh. After calculating, our answer is 2.38 times. Now go for the इट्स नेक्स्ट टॉपिक और नेक्स्ट रेशियो इज टोटल एसेट्स टर्नओवर रेशियो. दिस रेशियो इंडिकेट्स हाउ एफिशिएंटली टोटल एसेट्स आर यूज्ड टू जनरेट सेल्स. फॉर द नेट एसेट्स वी शुड डिडक्ट द इंटेंजिबल एसेट्स एंड सम इंटेंजिबल एसेट्स आर प्रिलिमिनरी एक्सपेंसेज, डिस्काउंट ऑन डिवेंचर और डिस्काउंट ऑन इशू ऑफ डिवेंचर, लॉस ऑन इशू ऑफ डिवेंचर, प्रॉफिट एंड लॉस, डेबिट बैलेंस, ब्रोकरेज एटसेट्रा. सो टोटल एसेट टर्नओवर रेशियो फॉर्मूला इज सेल्स डिवाइडेड बाय टोटल एसेट्स. हियर सेल्स मीन्स नेट सेल्स एंड टोटल एसेट्स मीन्स हियर इंटेंजिबल एसेट्स शुड बी डिडक्टेड. लुक ऑन इलस्ट्रेशन, फॉलोइंग इन्फॉर्मेशन इज गिवेन. टोटल एसेट्स 10 लाख, सेल्स 50 लाख, प्रिलिमिनरी एक्सपेंसेज 3 लाख. सो वी शुड डिडक्ट प्रिलिमिनरी एक्सपेंसेज फ्रॉम द टोटल एसेट्स. आफ्टर डिडक्टिंग आवर आंसर इज 7 लाख. 10 लाख माइनस 3 लाख इज इक्वल टू 7 लाख. सो फॉर्मूला इज टोटल एसेट टर्नओवर रेशियो इज इक्वल टू सेल्स डिवाइड बाय टोटल टेंजिबल एसेट्स. सेल्स इज 50 लाख एंड टेंजिबल एसेट्स इज 7 लाख. आफ्टर कैलकुलेटिंग आवर आंसर इज 7.14 टाइम्स. थैंक यू फॉर इन्वेस्टिंग योर टाइम. इफ यू लाइक द वीडियो, टर्न ब्लैक लाइक बटन इंटू ब्लू. सजेस्ट मी ऑन कमेंट बॉक्स. सब्सक्राइब माई चैनल एंड हेल्प मी. थैंक यू.